Ariel, listen to me. The human world, it's a mess. Life under the sea is better than anything they got up there. The seaweed is always greener in somebody else's lake. You dream about going up there, but that is a big mistake. Just look at the world around you, right here on the ocean floor. Such wonderful things around you. What more is you looking for? Under the sea, under the sea. Darling, it's better down where it's wetter. Take it from me. Up on the shore, they work all day. Out in the sun, they slave away. While we devoting full time to floating under the sea. Down here, all the fish is happy as off through the waves they roll.
Hi everyone, so as you've already seen, today's video is a cage theme, and it is a cage theme of the Little Mermaid. So this is what the cage looks like. I'm really pleased with it because it's taken me a while to make a lot of the DIYs. I'm going to now give you an in-detail tour of everything and show you all of the bits and bobs they've got in their cage. And for those of you that are wondering, this is Bailey, Dotty and Radish's cage. So let's start on the outside. I've put this thick blue ribbon to make it look a bit like there's the sea or the ocean, and then just above it on the see-through glass I've put Ariel, Flounder and Sebastian just there. Over here in this corner where the guinea pigs can't reach, I put this sparkly balloon decoration. It's a balloon weight actually, but I thought it went really well with the theme. On the walls I've put a few Little Mermaid decorations. I got this ribbon and this goes all the way around. I haven't sellotaped it, I've just put it across the hooks and the hay rack. Here I've got a little Ariel teddy and it's a little hanging one so they can't reach it, and even if they can reach it, which they won't go for because there's a bowl underneath and it's fairly high, they can't really do much damage to it or have damage to themselves because it's just a plushy toy. Then we've got some Baby Link toys here. I thought I'd add a bit of colour so it looks like a colourful ocean. For the bedding I used Blue Care Fresh. So just at the back here we've got a couple of homemade toys. The one on the left, the green one, is supposed to look like seaweed. I know it doesn't very much, but I wanted to make something that kind of represented seaweed, and I thought I could always put treats on that and things like that to make it more interesting for them. It's just made of lollipop sticks and a wooden block that's been dyed with safe food colouring. And then the little box down here is my little box of treasures, and it's got a cover box with seaside themed wooden chews that have all been painted with soy paint in there. It just gives me something a bit different other than a chew toy made of wood or either cardboard, and it's just a bit of a different thing for them to do. Over in the back corner here, this is my favourite DIY for this cage theme, and it took me a while to make and it was completely free. So all I did was get a cardboard box, use my soy paint and the chews that I had, painted them and stuck them all on. So there are some wooden chews on there, and I've just painted Ariel and Flounder on there. And I know they're not the greatest of paintings, but I was really pleased with them and how they turned out, and hopefully the guinea pigs like it too. And I've just made a little door rather than an opening so that it looks kind of different. They seem to like it. There we go, Radish has come to have a look. But this is definitely my favourite out of the whole cage because it took me quite a while to draw and make, and like I said, it cost me absolutely nothing. Just over here we've got another homemade toy. This is just a cardboard ring with wooden chews on it. We also have one of my homemade lollipop chews here, and again it's been made blue to match the seaside and the Little Mermaid theme. Just behind Radish at the back here we have got the Little Mermaid's castle. So I got this cut out and thought it would be perfect to put on the side as their little castle, because the underwater castle in the film of course is yellow, so I thought that would look really really nice with the theme. We have a green toy just here, and it's just one of those barrel and ball toys. Underneath the hay rack we've got another one of the little treasure box type things with some chews in there, and I've also got a homemade lollipop chew with a crab on, and then above that of course is the hay rack. The guinea pigs also have three blue jingly toys in the cage. As again Radish is demonstrating, just next to their other hide, we've got this fish plate, and I've just put some Pets at Home pellets on this. I actually smashed this plate. I did manage to glue it together, but I won't be leaving this in the cage permanently. I'm just using it as a treat ball, and I use soy paint to fix all the cracks, so it's all pet safe, no toxic paints on there or anything, but I don't want to risk leaving it in the cage unattended. But for the theme, I think it looks really cute and colourful and matches the theme just as I wanted it to. So here is their second hidey house. I've just decided to put quite an open one in, as the cob box only has one entrance, and as you can see, Bailey is very territorial. And Dottie is just under there at the moment. It is just a blue step stool, and it works really well because it's got four exits and entrances. Just down the side here, they have a children's pot toy that they like to throw about. And at the back here, we've got a couple more toys. On the left is something I really like and I was excited about finding and getting. It's just this plushy toy, and it's a little fish, and they seem to really like this already. It's such a soft, nice toy, and the tail crinkles. I don't know if they like that yet, they haven't shown interest in it, but they so far really like the fish, and I think it looks super cute. And then just here I made another homemade toy, and this is just a treasure chest that I thought would go with kind of under the water theme, especially with Ariel, where she collects all her treasures and things like that. I had some spare ribbon left and just decided to kind of drape it over this divider here. I also forgot to mention that the guinea pigs do also have this green and purple tunnel, but Bailey was getting a little bit naughty with it, so I decided to take it out for the cage tour, but they do also have this in to match the theme. And here's another overview of my The Little Mermaid guinea pig cage theme. So that is my cage theme for The Little Mermaid. I really hope you enjoyed watching this video. I really enjoyed making this, and it's taking me quite a while, longer than I probably should have to make this theme. But I really hope you like it. I've got lots of other cage themes on my channel, but I'm planning to do a lot more in the future too. So check out my playlist for cage themes if you're interested in seeing more. Thank you so much for watching. Remember to comment and like if you enjoyed this, and I'll see you all next time. Bye everyone.